Police say this man drove his truck into a car dealership because he was a disgruntled customer. And now, only on four, that man is telling an entirely different story.
And all of a sudden, I see my truck rolling by, and it wasn't nothing planned.
Well, Channel 4 Action News reporter Marcy Cipriani live now with the details, only on four. Marcy.
Well, Wendy, Robert Snatchko tells me he was here at the dealership in line waiting to see a technician when he got out of his vehicle, and he says it drifted into the building where you can see that plywood at the top of the building.
And all of a sudden, I see my truck rolling by, and it wasn't nothing planned.
Robert Snatchko is angry, upset, and hurt. He says the crash at Vasko Dodge was an innocent accident that damaged his truck, the dealership's building, and ended with him stunned, beaten, and put in jail. Snatchko tells me none of this was his intent, that he simply came here to have his new truck serviced.
I was waiting in line to get service, and I thought I had it in park, so I reached over to put my cigarette out, and the truck just rolled by about a half mile an hour, went through the glass windows.
Snatchko tells me he was out of his truck at the time, feet away at this ashtray, and before he could react, he says the owner came outside.
I kept saying it's an accident. I didn't try this. You know, he was mad, screaming, "I'm gonna effing kill you. I'm gonna effing kill you." He punched me in the head three times, knocked me down to the ground, and bounced my head off the glass.
These are the injuries Snatchko says he suffered from the beating. I went to the dealership to ask about those claims.
Please, I'm not doing an interview.
But was asked to leave instead. Police say Vasco's owner tells them Snatchko threatened to drive through the dealership a day before this happened. Snatchko admits to me he was angry over issues with his truck on Tuesday, and he says he did threaten the dealership's owner, but not with damage.
I called him up and told him I was going to have a sign across the street saying, "Please don't buy here. They forget you after the sale."
But Snatchko tells me his dispute with Vasco's owners was settled, that he was here for service, and this crash was an innocent mistake, and he plans to fight to clear his name.
I'm not this kind of monster that I was portrayed out to be.
Snatchko tells me he plans to press charges against the dealership's owner, and he says he plans to sue as well. Reporting live in Washington County, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.